We also have another question. Did you want to read it, James?
I'm gonna see how good these new glasses are for me. The person who's asking the question is Nirowit.
Yep, Nirowit.
And they ask, what is something you do to make sure that you're always improving as a designer?
That's a good question.
Yeah. Nick?
I'm always viewing other designers. I'm always leveling myself with other designers.
He's got a pair of binoculars.
No, gosh. I got them out. No. Yeah, I'm always comparing myself to other designers. I think you have to have a certain mindset to do that. I think comparing yourself to other designers can be a dangerous game if you aren't careful.
Right.
But I enjoy the competition. I enjoy looking at other people and be like, dang, they do great work, and I'm going to push myself to be better than them. And that's me. Not everyone's like that, but that's one way I'm always improving as a designer. How can I take, you know, the skill set that this designer really excels at and try to take some of that knowledge and implement into mine designs.
That's interesting. So the way that I typically go about it is actually when I see somebody mastering a certain skill,
yeah,
I just turn the other direction.
You break down and cry.
I do all the time. You should see my apartment full of Kleenex. I always pivot. I always try to go the other direction of where I see the herd moving.
And, okay. Well, it's a little, okay. I understand that too, but yeah, that's a little bit of a diversion from my comment.
Yeah. Well, no, it's not.
Yes, it is, Jay.
You're talking about being slightly competitive and like wanting to do stuff. But are you saying that you're taking bits of that person's skill and incorporating it into your work?
Yeah, it's not like I'm following a herd. Right. I think the herd thing is what...
No, I'm not saying you're a sheep.
I'm not
saying you're sheep.
I'm not putting... I don't know. What's a like trendy thing nowadays?
Oh, I don't know. What?
Sexy renders? I don't know.
Oh, render porn?
Yeah, I'm not... Well, I mean, I do like that, but...
Yeah, you've got some render porn.
Okay, continue your thing.
No.
So you turn the other way.
You don't oversaturate with renders.
Right.
Yeah. No, but what I'm saying is that I have this tendency of like, I don't even want to attempt to do what that person's doing. I want to just like do something different. I just want to do my own thing. And oftentimes I think that's to my detriment actually. Because I'm like, I feel like I do kind of get intimidated by certain skills, and I'm like, but like, I just end up trying to develop something different.
That's a good strategy too. I don't think it's a detriment, but I think that there is a chance in that strategy to really break out and do, like for me, here's an example.
Yeah.
When I first saw VR,
right,
my friend Leighton McDonald was the one that showed it to me. And I was like, whoa, this is something new that no one is doing. This is something that for your strategy, you could turn away and go do it,
right,
and build it out.
Yeah.
And I think I really built out that
yeah,
skill set. And it's really, you know, I don't know, it's, I feel like I'm pretty known for that.
Yeah.
Now.
No, you're a pioneer.
Right.
And I'm not saying when I'm saying this, I'm not saying that you are somebody who's like leading the herd. I think that you are a unique voice,
right,
in the Instagram community. And like, so when I see you doing that, I'm like, well, I'm not going to do VR sketching. Like I would incorporate that into like my workflow otherwise, but I wouldn't necessarily be like, you know what? I'm going to make that my thing too.
And that is a key difference in this topic, I think, is that one, we're talking about how do you differentiate yourself as a designer on Instagram and as your personal brand.
Right.
And then the other is like, how do you prove your actual workflow as a designer?
So I would say,
I was speaking to my workflow, like,
right,
how can I take these bits and pieces and like go and work for a client and make their product great?
Right.
You're saying like, how do I build my own personal brand as a designer?
Yeah. Okay. So in terms of like improving myself as a designer, I'm far more interested right now in developing my personal philosophy because I want to be more consistent in terms of like how I approach a project, how I think about a project, how I extrapolate like what like the big idea is.
Right.
And I've been very just totally fascinated with Stefano Giovannoni, who's like the top selling designer for Alessi, like over and over.
Right.
And I'm just, because his work, I was listening to a lecture that he gave today, or just like a video, TED-like video.
Right.
Where he was just talking about like, oh, I didn't really design much. I just like this is the idea. Like this is the manifestation of my philosophy.
Right.
And so, you know, I feel like there are times where we break through, and like, for instance, when you thought of the birdhouse for your MakerBot project, like that was just like came fully formed because it was the essence of a philosophy that you are developing for yourself.
Yeah.
And so for me, what I'm trying to do as well is trying to develop this philosophy where the products, like the decision making for the products, is much easier because the philosophy, right.
You put it in your philosophy machine, yeah, and it comes out the full product.
Exactly.
Okay. I like that. That's a cool idea, cool way to think about it.
You know, of course, like on a more foundational level, I'm always sketching. I'm always pushing myself in terms of my ideas. I think like doing exercises, like, you know, when I did like the car this week, it was just like, I'm just going to take a couple hours and I'm just going to do this.
Yeah.
And that was a challenge to myself because that type of car, like a lot of the designs that I had been doing for the toys were very like much more geometric, I would say.
Right.
And this was trying to do something a bit more fluid.
Mm-hmm.
So that was in itself a challenge, and to take notes from the inspiration and take the essence of the inspiration and put it into the car. Like, you know, that was a whole exercise in itself. But yeah, again, it was deeper than just hard skills themselves. It was like, I don't know. It was an exercise in also kind of understanding somebody else's philosophy. I don't know.
Yeah. No, I like your idea about the philosophy, like machine. That's interesting.
Yeah.
But thanks for sending it in, Neurowit. That was a great question.